Blessed are you, O God, our Father. Blessed are you, Lord Jesus Christ. Blessed are you, Holy Spirit of God. Blessed be Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. I greet you in the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Three persons, but one God. May his blessings be upon you all. As we remain standing, we pray together. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory be to God on high. The Lord be with you. Let us kneel to pray. Almighty God, you show to those who are in error the light of your truth, that they may return to the way of righteousness. May we and all who have been admitted into the fellowship of faith in Christ Reject those things which are contrary to our profession, and follow all things as agreeable to the same, through Jesus Christ our Lord. God our Father, Lord of all the world, we thank you that through your Son you have called us into the fellowship of your universal church. Hear our prayer for your faithful people, that in our vocation and ministry we may be instruments of your love, and give your servants now to be ordained the needful gifts of grace, through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Please sit for the Bible readings.
The ministry of the word. The lesson is taken from the book of Prophet Isaiah, chapter 6, verses 1 to 8. In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord seated on a throne, high and exalted. Above him were seraphs, each with six wings. With two wings they covered their faces, with two they covered their feet, and with two they were flying. And they were calling to one another, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord Almighty, the whole earth is full of his glory." At the sound of their voices, the doorposts and treasures shook, and the temple was filled with smoke. "Woe to me," I cried, "I am ruined, for I am a man of unclean lips, and I live among a people of unclean lips, and my eyes have seen the King, the Lord Almighty." Then one of the seraphs flew to me with a live coal in his hand, which he had taken with tongs from the altar. With it he touched my mouth and said, "See, this has touched your lips. Your guilt is taken away, and your sin atoned for." Then I heard the voice of the Lord saying, "Whom shall I send, and who will go for us?" And I said, "Here am I, send me." This is the word of the Lord.
The epistle is written in 2 Timothy chapter 4, beginning at verse 1. In the presence of God and of Christ Jesus, who will judge the living and the dead, and in view of his appearing and his kingdom, I give you this charge. Preach the word, be prepared in season and out of season, correct, rebuke, and encourage with great patience and careful instruction. For the time will come when people will not put up with sound doctrine. Instead, to suit their own desires, they will gather around them a great number of teachers to say what their itching ears want to hear. They will turn their ears away from the truth and turn aside to myth. But you, keep your head in all situations, endure hardship, do the work of an evangelist, discharge all the duties of your ministry. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you. the continuation of the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. Let your waist be girded and your lamps burning, and you yourselves be like men who wait for their master, when he will return from the wedding, that when he comes and knocks, they may open to him immediately. Blessed are those servants whom the master, when he comes, will find watching. Assuredly, I say to you that he will gird himself and have them sit down to eat, and will come and serve them. And if he should come in the second watch, or come in the third watch, and find them so, blessed are those servants. This is the gospel of Christ.
Let us bow our heads for prayer. Almighty God, you have been keeping your church together and guiding her from one generation to another, choosing capable leaders for her. That you have done at this time. Help us to recognize your appointed messengers and grant us the grace to listen and do according to your bidding through them. We ask through Jesus Christ our Lord. It is exactly 10 years ago that we got elected as Bishop of Ijebu North. And as a result, had to leave Lagos Diocese, my beloved diocese, for Ijebu land. We give God all the glory for standing by us since then, even until now. My special appreciation and that of my family goes to the Dean Emeritus of our church and the Lord Bishop of Lagos and our Mama Lagos, the Most Reverend Dr. and Mrs. Ephraim Adebola Ademowo, for his special interest in us. The way he relates with his clergymen and wives has sincerely endeared the two of them to us. They are leaders of leaders. A man who knows the way, follows the way, and shows the way to others. One whose way of life agrees with the ethics of Christianity. Papa is a mentor who is concerned about the welfare of his staff. And Papa and Mama can go to any length to make them comfortable. They are hospitable and generous to a fault. Thank you, Papa and Mama, for inviting me to lead the retreat and preach at this ordination service. And let me quickly say congratulations for celebrating the life and times of your mama here in this cathedral some weeks ago, and the two weddings of your sons. I will call it a Trinity celebration, which happened within a single year. Congratulations, Papa. Congratulations, Ma. On behalf of the Church of God, we welcome the new entrants into the church ministry and pray that their ministry will be fruitful, their ministry will be successful, their ministry will be beneficial to all mankind in the mighty name of Jesus. We want to recognize the presence of the former deputy governor of our great state, the Center of Excellence, Lagos State, Mama Orelokwe Adefulire. You have always been here. We have known you as a member of this family the family of our Papa and Mama Ademowo, God will bless you and your family in the mighty name of Jesus. Also want to welcome to this cathedral, to this service, the representative of the primate of all Nigeria, whose brother is being ordained today here. The General Secretary of the Church of Nigeria, I say welcome to Lagos. I want to greet all the diocesan officials, the Chancellor, the Deputy Chancellor, the Registrar, and all other legal luminaries for their wonderful support that they have been giving to our great Church Father, the Dean Emeritus and the Bishop of Lagos. To the entire good people of Lagos Diocese, lay and clergy, my people in Ijebu North are saying, Ewe so, Adarari Dede well. God bless you all in Jesus' name. Papa, I want to thank you for your encouragement. It was an encouragement that enabled me to pursue my education even to the PhD level. I pray that your own children will also prosper in life in the mighty name of Jesus. The theme of this message is messengers with a message. Messengers with a message. And the text is taken from 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 2. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 2. Preach the word. Be instant in season, out of season. Reprove, rebuke, exhort with all longsuffering and doctrine. The New King James Version says, preach the word. Be ready in season and out of season. Convince, rebuke, exhort with all longsuffering and teaching. St. Paul wrote two letters to Timothy, his spiritual son, whom he had left at Ephesus to organize and lead the church in that great city of Asia Minor. This second letter was written while Paul the Apostle was awaiting trial in prison in Rome. Paul had been accused of propagating an illegal religion at a time when the Roman Empire insisted on emperor worship under Emperor Nero. Paul knew that he was facing death penalty. Paul called on his son Timothy to use the scriptures. And I'm calling on those to be ordained this morning that they should use the scriptures. Church leaders should remember that they are to use the scriptures, use the undiluted scriptures, the one that was handed over to us. In the scripture, you have the message. In other words, Christian leaders have a message. We have a message. Brothers in Christ, you have a message. You are not going to meet your congregation without a message. One anomaly noticeable in the body of Christ today is the presence of messengers running around without a message. An example of such messengers is Ahimaaz. You find his story in 2 Samuel chapter 18, verses 19 to 33. 2 Samuel chapter 18, verse 19 to verse 33, Ahimaaz. After the death of Absalom, Joab, the captain of David's army, sent Cushi with a message to the palace. But Ahimaaz volunteered himself to also deliver a message to the king, in spite of the fact that Joab reminded him that he had no reason to go since he had no message to deliver. He insisted that he would, and he was allowed to. The funny thing about this story is that Ahimaaz outran Cushi, who actually had a message to deliver. When Ahimaaz got to King David and he was interrogated, the emptiness of his message was laid bare, and the king therefore asked him to step aside for the person who actually had substance in his message. One cannot help but wonder what was the essence of Ahimaaz's effort, so much so that he outran the person who actually had a message. The attitude demonstrated by Ahimaaz can be referred to as zeal without meaning. This is the situation of some so-called ministers of the gospel today. They are messengers sent by their belly or sent by the devil. Romans chapter 16, verse 18. How do we know messengers without a message? We know them by their deceptive speeches, their diluted messages, which are geared towards making people feel good when they should be sober about their lifestyle of sin. Apostle Paul, while giving his final charge to Timothy, his son in Christ, and a young minister of the gospel, instructed him to preach the gospel, be instant in season and out of season, reprove, rebuke, exhort with all long suffering and doctrine. You are ordained today with a message. The message that will save lives. A message that will transform and change our society. A message of salvation. Message that will make them live a holy life. Romans chapter 1, verse 16 says, "For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth." The message of salvation is not a motivational speech. Motivational speech cannot be the word of God. Motivational speech cannot convert. It can never transform. It contains no rebuke, no reproof, and no doctrine. Our message from the Lord, hallelujah. This message unto you I gave, is recorded in his word, hallelujah. It is only that you look and live. Look and live, my brother's name. Look to Jesus now and live. It's recorded in his word, hallelujah. It is only that you look and live. You have a message. Go and preach the word. The purpose of preaching is to effect changes among the members of God's church that build them up individually and that build them up the body as a whole, according to Romans chapter 14, verse 19, 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 11. This letter was written when it was not safe to be a preacher. Paul was sentenced to death because of this same message of the gospel. He was sentenced to death, and he was ready to die. He was prepared to suffer for the gospel. Those of you who are coming new into the church ministry, are you ready to suffer for Christ? Can you give your life like Paul, as he did? When after preaching the gospel, he was ready for death. What is the situation of the society or country that you are called to minister to today. The situation of Nigeria today, Nigeria is no longer safe. Our society is no longer friendly to the gospel. Our society that is not friendly to the gospel, especially in the north, a society that is morally degenerated, a society that is corruption friendly, a society where the rich men look down on the poor as if they are not created by God, a society where joblessness is the order of the day, a society that is sick and in need of spiritual solution, a society where truth is hated, a society where people are religious but are not spiritual, a society where those who amass wealth dubiously are recognized, and even in the church, they are given chieftaincy titles, while those who laid down their lives for the country and for the gospel remain unpopular and uncelebrated. You also have a church that is weak spiritually and divided. But you have a message. Paul says the message is urgent. Go and deliver it. Don't delay. It must be preached. It can cost you your comfort. You can lose your life or the life of your precious wife or children. The gospel must be preached. Tell them the truth. Tell them their errors. The high and the mighty will come to your church to worship, and they will listen to your message. Give them the undiluted message. Some of these influential persons, they have no one to tell them what they are doing is wrong. Who can tell a governor what he's doing is wrong? It is the man of God. The people on the street cannot face them. Other high and mighty will see nothing wrong in what they are doing. But you, because of the Spirit of God in your life, you should be able to boldly tell them their mistakes. Tell them that if they do not change, they will go to hell. Tell them that hell is real and heaven is also real. The president of this country, Uruguay, according to what I read from the internet, a whole president is the poorest and the most generous president in all the world as of today. The poorest president is also the most generous president in all the world. He goes about in a Volkswagen car, a president. Can that happen in Nigeria? He gives 90% of his salary every month to the poor and the needy. A president. Who can do that in Nigeria? Former deputy governor. Can that be done? Beloved people of this diocese, my Lord Bishop, the Archbishop, can we do that? Even bishops, can we forego our comfort so that the people of Nigeria can enjoy? That is the type of change we should be looking for in Nigeria. Change. When a president of a country can go about in a Volkswagen car, who am I? When I was given a Tokumbo car as a welcome gift as a bishop, I frowned. Why must a whole bishop be welcomed with a Tokumbo car in a brand new diocese? Why not with a brand new car, tear rubber? But you can see a whole president going about in a Volkswagen car. We have to humble ourselves. Humility. That is what we need in Nigeria. When those in position of authority will think more about the masses and how to make life easy for them, God will help us in Jesus' name. Paul says, be instant in season and out of season. This work must be done at all times. It is not only when you are in the church or when the security of the country is fine and there is peace that you can preach. You preach when it is convenient and when it is not convenient for you. Preach even when death threatens you. Reprove. Reprove not merely those erring in doctrine, but generally those who are blameworthy. Anybody that is blameworthy in your church, reprove them. Correct them. Let them know that what they are doing is wrong. People don't want to hear that what they are doing is wrong. They want you to praise them to the high heavens. But you are not ordained for that. Tell them the truth. If the truth is not spoken in the church, where else shall we hear the truth? Rebuke them. This is a more sharper and severe word than the preceding. Rebuke all sinners. Sinners should be rebuked. All that live an ill life should be rebuked. Some privately and gently, while some others roughly, depending on the circumstance. Ezekiel chapter 13, verse 18 says, "Will you hunt the souls of my people? And will you save the souls of those who come unto you?" What will you do? Will you save the souls of those who come to listen to God's word? Exhort. Speak comfortable words, words of encouragement and hope to all, especially the dispirited and the sad-hearted. Ensure that the teaching which is right and true and full of hope accompanies your rebuke and words of comfort. Beloved, please love your members. Love the sinners and bring them to Christ. Don't allow any one of them to perish due to your carelessness. 2 Timothy chapter 3, 16 and 17 says, "All scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God may be complete, thoroughly equipped for every good work." Finally, as I congratulate those to be ordained, I charge the whole congregation where these people of God are to serve, to cooperate with them. Support them with your prayers. Support them with your money. Because, as we normally say here in Lagos, anointing without money is what? Is annoyance. Support them with your money. Support them with good advice. Servants of the living God, you have a great work given to you, a great assignment committed to your task. Therefore, as you go to lead the people in worship, worship God like Abel. Walk before God like Enoch. Obey God like Noah. Believe in God like Abraham. Be faithful to God like Moses. Lead the people of God like Joshua. Serve the Lord like Samuel. Trust God like David. Walk like Nehemiah. Fast. Do you want me to repeat that? Fast. Some of us don't fast. But you must fast. If you want to make a headway, if you want to chase away Satan, the devil, from your congregation, from your family, you must fast like Esther. Be godly like Job. Weep for your sin. Weep for the sins of your congregation like Jeremiah. Pray like Daniel. Preach like Paul the Apostle, and live like Jesus. And now to the eternal Trinity, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, be all honor, dominion, and power, now and forevermore.
the persons who you present to us are suitable and qualified in their learning and character to exercise their ministry to the honor of God and the edifying of His church.
I have examined them and found them so to be.
My dear people of God, those whose duty it is to inquire about these persons and examine them have found them to be of godly life and sound learning, and believe them to be duly called to serve God in this ministry. We gather here as members of the one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church to witness the ordination of this ordinance into the church ministry. It is your duty, if any one of you knows any impediment or notable crime in any of these persons presented to us, to be ordained deacons, for which he should not be admitted to that office, to let us know in the name of God and tell us such crime or impediment. Is it therefore your wish that they should be admitted to this office? Will you uphold them in their ministry?
Reverend Father in God, I present Adekul Obina Bright. Emmanuel Ogenero Mason. Uche Shuku Seli. Oko Ewele Silas. Olorundare Adebayo Jacob. To be ordained to the office of priest in the church of God.
Make sure that the persons who you present to us suitable and qualified in their learning and character to exercise their ministry to the honor of God and the edifying of His church.
I have examined them and found them suitable.
My dear people of God, those whose duty it is to inquire about these persons and examine them have found them to be of godly life and sound learning, and believe them to be duly called to serve God in this ministry. We gather here as members of the one holy, Catholic and Apostolic Church to witness the ordination of these ordinands into the Church's ministry. It is your duty, if any one of you knows any impediment or notable crime in any of these persons presented to us, to be ordained priests, for which he should not be admitted to that office, to let us know in the name of God and tell us such crime or impediment. Is it therefore your wish that they should be admitted to this office? Will you uphold them in their ministry? Deacon is called to serve the Church of God and to work with its members in caring for the poor, the needy, the sick, and all those who are in trouble. He is to strengthen the faithful, search out for the careless and the indifferent, and to preach the word of God in the place to which he is licensed. The deacon assists the priests under whom he serves in leading
worship of the people, especially in the administration of the Holy Communion. He may baptize when required to do so. It is his general duty to do such pastoral work as is entrusted to him, in order that we may know your mind and purpose, and that you may be strengthened in your resolve to fulfill your ministry. You must make the declaration we now put to you. Do you believe, so far as you know in your heart, that God has called you to the office and work of a deacon in this church? Do you accept the Holy Scriptures as revealing all things necessary for eternal salvation through faith in Jesus Christ? Do you believe the doctrine of the Christian faith as the Church of Nigeria has received it? And will you in your ministry expound and teach it? Will you accept the discipline of this church and give due respect to those in authority? Will you be diligent in prayer, in reading Holy Scriptures, and in all studies that will deepen your faith and fit you to uphold the truth of the gospel against error? Will you strive to fashion your own life and that of your household according to the way of Christ? Will you promote unity, peace, and love among all Christian people, and especially among whom you serve? Will you then, in the strength of the Holy Spirit, continually stir up the gift of God that is in you to make Christ known to all people? Almighty God, who has given you the will to undertake all these things, give you also the strength to perform them, that you may complete that work which he has begun in you, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Thank you.
body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit, all baptized people are called to make Christ known as Savior and Lord and to share in the renewing of his world. Now, you are called to walk as pastors, priests, prophets, and teachers, together with your bishop and fellow clergy, and to take your share in the councils of the church. As priests, it will be your task to proclaim by word and deed the gospel of Christ Jesus, and to fashion your life in accordance with his precepts. You are to love and serve the people among whom you walk, caring alike for young and old, strong and weak, rich and poor. You are to preach, to declare God's forgiveness to penitent sinners, to pronounce God's blessing, to preside at the administration of holy baptism and at the celebration of the miseries of Christ's body and blood, and to perform the other ministrations entrusted to you. In all that you do, you are to nourish Christ's people from the riches of his grace and strengthen them to glorify God in this life and in the life to come. Because you cannot bear the weight of this ministry in your own strength, but only by the grace and power of God, pray earnestly for his Holy Spirit. Pray that he will each day enlarge and enlighten your understanding of the scriptures, so that you may grow stronger and more mature in your ministry. We trust that long ago you began to weigh and ponder all this, and that you are fully determined by the grace of God to give yourselves fully to his service and devote to him your best powers of human spirit, so that as you daily follow the rule and teaching of our Lord with the heavenly assistance of his Holy Spirit, you may grow up into his likeness and sanctify the lives of all with whom you have to deal, in order that we may know your mind and purpose, and that you may be strengthened in your resolve to fulfill your ministry. You must make the declarations we now put to you. Do you believe, so far as you know your own heart, that God has called you to the office and work of a priest in his church? Do you now, in the presence of this church, commit yourselves to this trust and responsibility? Do you accept the Holy Scriptures as revealing all things necessary for eternal salvation through faith in Jesus Christ? Are you determined to be diligent in the reading and study of the Holy Scriptures, and in seeking the knowledge of such things, and may make you a stronger and more able minister of Christ? Do you believe the doctrine of the Christian faith as the Church of Nigeria has received it, and in your ministry, will you expound and teach it? Will you accept the discipline of this church and give due respect to those in authority? Will you respect and be guided by the pastoral direction and leadership of your bishop and other senior ministers under whom you are to serve? Will you undertake to be faithful pastor to all whom you are called to serve, laboring together with them and with your fellow ministers to build up the family of God? Will you endeavor to minister the word of God and the sacraments of the new covenant, the
that the reconciling love of Christ will be known and received. Will you promote unity, peace, and love among all Christian people, and especially among those whom you serve? Will you strive to fashion your own life and that of your household according to the way of Christ? Will you be diligent in prayer, in reading Holy Scriptures, and in all studies that will deepen your faith and fit you to uphold the truth of the gospel against error?
Almighty God, who has given you the will to undertake all these things, give you also the strength to perform them, that he may complete that work which he has begun in you, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Speak the prayers of the faithful for these servants of the Lord, that their ministry will be productive, that their ministries will be fruitful, that they will never leave the word of God and be serving tables, that the Spirit of the living God daily will fall afresh on them.
Lord, the Son.
those who pray in the name of your Son, grant that what we have asked in faith, we may obtain according to your will, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Like the first disciples, waiting for your coming, empowering Spirit, we walk and pray. Receive the Holy Spirit for the office and work of a deacon in the Church of God, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Take the authority to do the work of a deacon in the Church of God, committed to your charge. Holy Spirit for the office and work of a deacon in the Church of God, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Take the authority to do the work of a deacon in the Church of God, committed to your charge. Receive the Holy Spirit for the office and work of a deacon in the Church of God, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Take the authority to do the work of a deacon in the Church of God, committed to your charge. Receive the Holy Spirit for the office and work of a deacon in the Church of God, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Take the authority to do the work of a deacon in the Church of God, committed to your charge. Receive the Holy Spirit for the office and work of a deacon in the Church of God, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Take the authority to do the work of a deacon in the Church of God, committed your charge. church of God, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Take the authority to do the work of a deacon in the church of God, committed to your charge. Heavenly Father, thank you most sincerely, because the church is marching on. The gates of hell will never prevail against your church. We thank you for these walls who are armies of Christ. You have called them. They have responded to your call. Father, we pray that they will never fail. These walls will never fail. These ones will never falter. Their ministries will never be interrupted in the name of Jesus Christ. These ones will never fall by the wayside in the name of Jesus. From time to time, they will hear your voice talking with them in the name of Jesus. The message they will preach from time to time will come from you in the name of Jesus. Thus says the Lord, that will be their message in the name of Jesus. Father, may they seek your kingdom and your righteousness. You have promised that other things will be added. These ones, they will get their priorities right with you in the name of Jesus. When they go out, you go out with them. When they come in, you come in with them. Their ministries will never be deficient. Their ministries, gracious Lord, will attract many people to Christ in the name of Jesus. They will never leave the word of God and be serving tables in the name of Jesus. It is well with you. It is well with your ministries. It is well with your homes. In Jesus' name we pray. We celebrate the gift of ordained ministry in God's church. Will you greet your new ministers and welcome them in Christ's name? Thank you. God is here, let us continue in prayer. We praise and glorify you, Almighty Father, because you have formed throughout the world a holy people for your own possession, a royal priesthood, a universal church. We praise and glorify you because you have given us your only Son, Jesus Christ, to be the apostle and high priest of our faith and shepherd of our souls. We praise and glorify you that by his death he has overcome death, and that having ascended into heaven, he has given his gifts abundantly, making some apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors and teachers to equip your people for the work of ministry and to build up his body. And now we give you thanks that you have called these your servants, whom we ordain in your name, to share the ministry entrusted to your church. May they exalt you, O Lord, in the midst of your people. May they offer spiritual sacrifices acceptable to you. May they boldly proclaim the gospel of salvation, rightly administer the sacraments of the new covenant. As you have called them to your service, make them worthy of their calling. Make them faithful pastors, patient teachers, and wise counselors. Make them modest, humble, strong, constant, observe the disciplines of Christ. Grant them that in all things they may serve without reproach, so that your people may be strengthened and your name glorified in all the world. Accept these prayers, most merciful Father, through your Son Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit belong glory and honor, worship and praise, now and forever. Amen. Thank you.
the office and work of a priest in the Church of God, now committed to you by the imposition of our hands. Whose sins you forgive, they are forgiven. And whose sins you retain, they are retained. And be a faithful dispenser of the word of God and of the holy sacraments, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Anointed servant of God, do your prophetic and priestly work according to the order of Christ, your Lord and Savior. May He bless your ministry. Receive this Bible as a sign of authority which God has given you this day, to preach the gospel of Christ and to minister His holy sacraments. Receive the Holy Spirit for the office and work of a priest in the Church of God, now committed to you by the imposition of our hands. Whose sins you forgive, they are forgiven. And whose sins you retain, they are retained. And be a faithful dispenser of the word of God and of the holy sacraments. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Anointed servant of God, do your prophetic and priestly work according to the order of Christ, your Lord and Savior. May He bless your ministry. Receive this Bible as a sign of authority which God has given you this day, to preach the gospel of Christ and to minister His holy sacraments.
intercession of our hands, whose sins you forgive, they are forgiven. And whose sins you retain, they are retained. And be a faithful dispenser of the word of God and of the holy sacraments. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Servant of God, do your prophetic and priestly work according to the order of Christ, your Lord and Savior. May He bless your ministry. Receive this Bible as a sign of authority which God has given you this day to preach the gospel of Christ and to minister His holy sacraments. The office and work of a priest in the Church of God now committed to you by the imposition of our hands. Whose sins you forgive, they are forgiven. And whose sins you retain, they are retained. And be a faithful dispenser of the word of God and of the holy sacraments in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Servant of God, do your prophetic and priestly work according to the order of Christ, your Lord and Savior. May He bless your ministry. Receive this Bible as a sign of authority which God has given you this day to preach the gospel of Christ and to minister His holy sacraments. Receive the Holy Spirit, for the office and work of a priest in the Church of God, now committed to you by the imposition of our hands. Whose sins you forgive, they are forgiven. And whose sins you retain, they are retained. And be a faithful dispenser of the word of God and of the holy sacraments. In the name of the Father, and and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Lord will bless you indeed. The Lord will enlarge your coast. His hand will be upon you for good in the name of Jesus. It will be well with you. It will be well with you. Each time you call on the Lord, He will never forsake you. Your prayers will be answered. Your priorities will be rightly arranged in the name of Jesus Christ. You will never leave the Word of God and be serving tables in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Celebrate the gift of ordained ministry in God's church. Will you meet your new ministers and welcome them in Christ's name? Reconciled us to God in one body by the cross. We meet in His name and share His peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Let us offer one another a sign of peace.
You
boast of your gift to us by giving us more laborers in your vineyard. So, Lord, we thank you for extending that gift to us by giving us the grace to give from what you have given us. Unto your merciful hands we commit ourselves and the gifts of your children. Father, accept them. Bless them. May we grow in the spirit of giving. May we give ourselves always to your service. Father, may these gifts expand the coast of evangelism in our land. So that this, through this gift, O Father, will serve you the more. Through Christ.
Give thanks unto
accept our praises, Heavenly Father, through your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. As we follow his example and obey his command, granted by the power of your Holy Spirit, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us his body and his blood. In the same night that he was betrayed, he took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." The same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you should drink of it in remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ is God. Christ is risen. Christ will come. Therefore, Heavenly Father, we remember his offering of himself made once for all upon the cross and proclaim his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension. As we look for his coming in glory, we celebrate with this bread and this cup his one perfect sacrifice. Accept through him, our great high priest, this our sacrifice of thanks and praise. And as we eat and drink this holy gift in the presence of your divine majesty, renew us by your Spirit, inspire us with your love, and unite us in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him, and with him, and in him, by the power of the Holy Spirit, with all who stand before you in earth and in heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honor and glory and power be yours forever. Break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Father of all, we give you thanks and praise that when we were still far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home. Dying and living, he declared your love, gave us grace, and opened the gate of glory. May we who share Christ's body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to others. We whom the Spirit lights give light to the world. Keep us firm in the hope you have set before us, so we and your children shall be free. The whole earth live to praise your name through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please sit back. to us in the right of our bishopric, we, Adebola, lay gods, refer as archdeacon in the Diocese of Lagos, the Reverend Canon Stephen Olabanji Egbeola. Lord be with you. Let us pray. Let each and every one of us thank God for this opportunity of coming to worship. Desire those things that you want from the Lord and claim them, appropriate them for your life. All understanding. Keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Spirit be among you and remain with you